waiting for them back in Knoxville. The number two team in the nation, the South Carolina Gamecocks, are on Rocky Top tonight. Both of these teams near the top of the SEC standings in great position to earn that double bye in the SEC tournament coming up in a couple of weeks. South Carolina has not lost an SEC game. Tennessee sits at 6-3, third in the conference standings. SEC Network Women's Basketball presented by Regions. We are so excited to be with you, Courtney Lau, alongside national championship winning head coach Carolyn Peck. And if you want star power, we've got it in this game, including two players who made your list for candidates for SEC Player of the Year.
Well, when you look at this list of the potential SEC Player of the Year, you have to start first with this list of Chelsea Dungy, Aaliyah Boston, Ryan Howard, Ray Burrell, and India Jones. But Aaliyah Boston, she was the SEC Freshman of the Year last year. So this year, coming into her sophomore season, nothing less. And it's not just about stopping her in the paint. She has seen just about every kind of defense you could imagine. Double team, no problem. She can take it from the high post, but it's not just in the paint, but also she has the ability to pop out and knock it down from long range. But for the Lady Vols, Ray Burrell, she's shooting over 47% from the perimeter. And let me tell you, it doesn't matter. You may think that you have contested her shot, but if she's got daylight and can see it, she's going to make you pay. And don't go behind the screen. That's a big no-no when you're playing against Ray Burrell.
Ray Burrell has had double figures in all but two games. Aaliyah Boston coming in with three straight double-doubles to play in this incredible matchup we have here for you tonight, a top 25 battle. Tennessee will start out with the basketball first. It'll be Jordan Walker running the point to start this game for Tennessee.
And South Carolina said they're going to start out in a man-to-man. Dawn Staley said she was going to first try to pressure to disrupt.
Zaya Cook loses it, and Ray Burrell is there to scoop it. Can she score it? You bet. South Carolina has stuck with the starting lineup all season. Destiny Henderson, number three in the black jersey, is their point guard who's leading this group.
Well, in Tennessee, in a man-to-man defense, and you're not going to see a lot of double teams on Aaliyah Boston because Tennessee's got the link.
Tennessee, a new starting lineup. Jordan Horston has been starting at point guard for Tennessee, but tonight it's going to be Jordan Walker in that starting lineup. Here's Bree Beal, one of the outstanding sophomores, but turns it over. A couple of turnovers already for the Gamecocks. Burrell, the jumper.
Dawn Staley cannot be happy. Both times Tennessee has been able to score, it's because South Carolina has had unforced turnovers.
Zaya Cook at the elbow. I think Tamari Key might have got a piece of that ball, and Renaya Davis comes out with it, pushing for Tennessee. Dumps it off to Tamari Key, in and out.
The second and third opportunities makes Tennessee so good because they can crash the glass.
And when you need a bucket, apparently you just go to Ray Burrell. She has been so consistent for Tennessee this season.
Might as well call her Steady Eddie.
Up and in, Bree Beal, the bucket for South Carolina.
I'm going to keep an eye on the battle within the game. The bigs, the two bigs for South Carolina versus the two bigs of Tennessee.
Coach Kittawa dumps back to Ray Burrell. She scored Tennessee's first 6 points. It's so interesting to look at the statistics for both of these teams. They are very similar, especially in three key areas: rebounds per game, blocks per game, and paint points. This is all coming in SEC play.
Well, both coaches have similar mindset. The easy buckets should be the ones that come in that orange area. It's not just about getting it to your big players, but your guards getting a piece of that paint. playing as well. And then everybody's got to be committed to rebounding.
Interesting to see Jordan Walker getting the start at point guard for Tennessee tonight.
Well, especially as well as Jordan Worston has been taking care of the basketball. She's been distributing with her assist. One of the areas of improvement has been what a good job she's done at that point guard spot.
Yeah, Worston's last three games, she's had 14 assists and just three turnovers, but her shooting is struggling, just shooting 18% from the field during that stretch. Bree Beal.
Ooh, Walker had the opening. She was hesitant of taking the shot. She needed to pull the trigger.
That'll be a travel and the first turnover for Tennessee so far tonight. Kelly Harper's crew has been through a lot the last few days. They played Texas A&M, and that game was really close on Sunday until about the last 2 minutes of the game. A&M won by 10 points. But then they got stuck in Texas, finally back home and now ready to play the number two team in the nation.
Well, they didn't get home until Tuesday. Remember, their game was played on Sunday because the airport in Houston shut down because of that snowstorm.
There's going to be a foul down low on Cassie Cush-Kittawa.
You watch the battle of the post inside. Tamari Key and Aaliyah Boston. A lot of physical contact going on.
Hey, that's not new for Tennessee. They just played Texas A&M, as we mentioned on Sunday, who has two outstanding post players in India Jones and Sierra Johnson. And I thought, especially in that first half, Tennessee did a good job on their post players.
Yeah, they did. Tennessee did a nice job of just going direct pass into the post. The second half, the guards, they went away from that a little bit. And Texas A&M, they toughened the defense on the post game inside.
Four seconds on the shot clock for Tennessee. Walker drives it and comes up short. Zaya Cook can't get the layup to go. South Carolina has struggled with layups all season.
Layups and at the free throw line at key times. That's an area they got to clean.
Ray Burrell has all of Tennessee's points.
Good thing we had her in the highlight.
It makes you look real smart, right?
She's shooting. Look, 47%, and just going back on Synergy, watching her shots, it's not that that Ray Burrell is just making wide open shots. She's making contested ones. She makes tough shots as well.
Bree Beal up and around the rim. Victoria Saxton on cleanup duty.
Tennessee very patient with the offense. But what I'm impressed with, one of the things Dawn Staley said that she was going to do was that South Carolina was going to have to box out. That's not something that the Gamecocks normally do.
Tie game here in Knoxville. We'll take a look at South Carolina's point guard when we come back. Dawn Staley, the second black woman to win a national championship. That was back in 2017 with South Carolina. Last season, they were the number one team in the nation. Looked like they would be on track to win another title. But now the Gamecocks have to break in a new point guard. Destiny Henderson has been taking over this team for one of the best point guards in the nation, Dawn Staley.
And the thing that Henny is different in Ty Harris is the speed. She can blow by anyone, but she has the court vision. Recognize that when the ball gets into her hands, eyes are up, and she's looking to advance it down the floor. But Destiny Henderson is a scoring point guard as well, so when the defense sinks in, she can step right in and pop it from long distance and knock it down and make the defense have to pay. And then last but not least, Dawn Staley has the confidence to go isolation with Destiny Henderson. She feels like she can take anybody off the bounce, make the defense have to all collapse, and then Henderson will find the open shooter on the perimeter. But when the defense recovers, remember, Destiny Henderson can shoot the basketball, ladies and gentlemen. You better find her. Find number 3 for South Carolina.
And Henderson, since that UConn game where she played out of her game, Dawn Staley was not happy with her. They made the adjustments. Look at what she has done since then. In the following 2 games, she's averaged 15 points per game, shot 60% from the field, and limited her turnovers to just 2.5 a game.
When you're a scoring point guard like Destiny Henderson, you have to really be very selfless. And talking to Dawn Staley, she said at the point guard position, that's a servant's position. You've got to really concentrate on how you're going to make everybody else look good, just like getting the ball right there to Tamari Key. That makes Key look real good down low for Tennessee.
Tennessee starting a different point guard today with Jordan Walker, who obviously has played there this season, but we haven't seen her start with this particular lineup. Now Jordan Horston is in the game along with Marta Suarez for Tennessee. 5 seconds for Carolina. Almost lost it. Saved by Cook. The pull-up. It's a 2 off the mark.
Now with Marta Suarez in for the Lady Vols, that would be just a one-on-one isolation, but Tamari Key cannot allow Aaliyah Boston to push her that far out off the block.
Walker drives and has it poked away by Henderson. Can she corral it? Went out of bounds. It'll stay with Tennessee. South Carolina comes in having not lost an SEC game. They have won 31 straight SEC games. Just incredible. Of course, won that national championship, has already got 5 SEC regular season and 5 tournament titles to her name at South Carolina, and is also our Olympic team coach.
You see that speed of Destiny Henderson? I've been so impressed throughout the career of Dawn Staley and in watching how she communicates with the players. She's honest with them. She doesn't sugarcoat it, and their team, her players, they trust her, and they know that what she tells them is the truth. And Destiny Henderson, when she has conversations with Dawn Staley, Dawn tells her, listen, you've got to use your speed, but you've got to learn how to play with pace. Know when to slow it down and when to push. They have a great relationship, spend a lot of time watching film together.
Carolina will swing it back over to the other side. Boston trying to get through traffic in the post. No points so far for Aaliyah Boston. Henderson at the elbow. Renaya Davis gets blocked by Saxton.
Well, I expected this to be a block party both sides. The Lady Vols, they're known for their shot blocking ability also.
Jordan Horston with a pretty floater. Anaya Russell, the only freshman for South Carolina, drives in and draws the foul. South Carolina had that outstanding number one recruiting class last year that was the number one freshman class, so just one freshman this season. They've got another number one recruiting class coming in next season.
It just keeps rolling, and in talking to Dawn about how she got that number one recruiting class, especially during time of COVID, she said she really got able to develop a relationship in talking to players via Zoom or via FaceTime, and that communication, that constant communication, built that relationship. Just understand how strange that is, not allowed to come on campus for visits and making a decision where you're going to spend the next 4 years in college. You have to build a lot of trust.
Cleaning up a little blood on Aaliyah Boston. But, yeah, everything's been so weird. Everybody's just had to adapt and adjust and find new ways to still get the job done, because winning basketball games is still a priority.
And at both of these coaches, Kelly Harper, in just going into her second season and spending time with really building the trust between her players and understanding what she brought in last year, and now to see what they're doing this year, the progress that you can see on the court and how these players have developed.
Horsman at the point now for Tennessee. Going to the bucket, gets swatted away by Boston.
It's like Tennessee's playing against a mirror of itself with the length, because South Carolina can really match size for size with the Lady Vols.
This is probably the biggest team that South Carolina has faced too. Marta Suarez.
I like Suarez, this freshman from Spain. She plays with a lot of composure, great maturity on the court.
It'll stay with Tennessee. Suarez had a couple of big shots in their game on Sunday against Texas A&M. One right at the buzzer before the half to tie things up. And she's been dealing with a lower leg injury, so even more impressive.
Well, and Kelly Harper told us that Suarez is not able to do a lot of practicing, and just throughout the rest of the season, probably not going to heal, so she's had to be very disciplined on how much time she spends in practice and manage her minutes in games.
Key gets behind the defense of Leticia Amihir, and Tamari Key will head to the free throw line. First trip to the free throw line for Tennessee tonight.
Tamari
Destiny Key Salary checks in for Tennessee.
Tamari Key really has blossomed in her sophomore year, especially this second half of the SEC season.
Well, Monday we'll have our final True South episode of the season, and the trek takes you to Bowman, South Carolina. John T. Edge will reconnect with his family roots over liver pudding and catfish stew on the Edisto River. 7 Eastern, 6 Central, right here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. True South, presented by Yellowwood.
I have had catfish stew, but I've never had liver pudding.
Can't say I've had either. Lily Grissett. Little drama on the bucket, but it will count, and Tennessee can hold for the last shot of the quarter. High bank up off the backboard by Jordan Horston, and we are tied at 16 apiece. Aaliyah Boston already making an impact, though, with her defense.
It's been a battle inside.
They tried to make the best of the situation, though, when they were stuck in a hotel, couldn't get out of Houston. The Lady Vols, waiting to check into the hotel, decided to put on a little fashion show Sunday night as they waited to get the final word on what the team would be doing next. But I love it because we get to see a little personality from this group and talk about making the best of a tough situation. This team has certainly done that.
All right.
Well, when they came back from, look at Emily Saunders on the stroll. When they came back from College Station to Houston, I mean, and you're trying to just keep it lighthearted, not get your players worried. They found a way just to kind of break the tension and have a little fun.
Tennessee did end up finding a local gym on Tuesday that they could practice in for a little bit. They also gave him some free time in that gym. And Renaya Davis put together a little scrimmage between the team, and they were able to fly home late Tuesday night. But interesting travel woes to go along with what's already been an interesting season with stops and starts for pretty much every team. Destiny Henderson has come out with her offense tonight.
Well, Tennessee had changed up their defense, went to a 2-3 zone, and a lot of people may think South Carolina is questionable scoring from the perimeter, but they have found ways to turn it up when they've needed it.
Henderson already has 7 points. Rebound by Boston. Aaliyah Boston has not scored yet.
See, Tennessee still in that 2-3 zone. I think worried about Aaliyah Boston. You said she hadn't scored. But she's not going to quit on the glass. Even if she doesn't score on the first try, she's going to continue to go after it.
That foul's going to be on Destiny's salary. And now Aaliyah Boston will head to the free throw line. She's a 70% free throw shooter, looking for her first points tonight. Already has 6 rebounds and a couple of blocks.
We've got to keep an eye on Aaliyah Boston and any other of the post players from South Carolina coming in with her and seeing how does Tennessee handle that. Right now, Tennessee has 4 guards on the floor with Cassie Keshketawa.
Yeah, both these teams, they boast size, of course, and they boast a big post presence. South Carolina is going to make the substitution, too. They just took out Aaliyah Boston in favor of Victoria Saxton.
And see now, Ray Burrell playing the 4, and she and Renaya Davis, they're interchangeable. If a post is guarding Davis, you see Davis is out on the 3-point line.
Back inside to Kush Kittawa, is fouled by Saxton. Now you mentioned Renaya Davis. She had a great comeback game. Did not play a week ago tonight due to medical reasons against Kentucky. Came back against Texas A&M on Sunday, had 25 points.
The thing you can tell when Renaya Davis is going to have one of those games when she's crashing the board, she's active and moving, and the defense has to keep up with her and find out where she is. She will make you pay going in the lane, and then she'll pop out and hit that jumper.
Still looking for her first points tonight. So it'll be South Carolina ball. Now Meehir overthrows Saxton, and it'll be a turnover, number 5 for South Carolina.
That was a good look by Meehir. She knew before she caught it where she wanted to go with it instead of catching it and trying to figure it out.
Oh, Kush Kittawa found some space under the basket all alone. And Meehir travels. Back-to-back turnovers by South Carolina and Leticia Meehir.
Well, Tennessee going with that small lineup. You see the screen by Jordan Horston. That opens things up for Cassie Keshketawa. Again, going back to Ray Burrell playing the 4 for the Lady Vols. And if a post player is guarding Davis, Davis can pull that other post player away. So when a guard screens for Cassie Keshketawa, there's going to be a mismatch if they switch.
Here's Davis. Victoria Saxton's not going to let that pass go inside. Anaya Russell will go back to the free throw line. Second foul on Destiny Salary. She'll take a seat.
This is a slower paced game than what I was expecting. I know that South Carolina wanted this to be an up-tempo game, and Tennessee was going to try to force some turnovers of their own and get their tempo up as well.
Yeah, Dawn Staley told us she felt like if they could push the basketball, that would really help them against the height that Tennessee has, because that's an advantage when you settle into the half court.
And you want to be able to score before the defense gets set when you're facing Tennessee, because that length, they can take away lanes. They're also tremendous shot blockers.
Victoria Saxton gets the 2 points for Carolina.
Those offensive rebounds off a free throw will drive a coach nuts, because you have the inside position to box out. There's no way a team should be able to get an offensive rebound.
Gamecocks on the move. Henderson pulls the trigger in the corner, gets her own rebound.
You watch Victoria Saxton that just reads it off the missed free throw. This is, you've got inside position to box out. Victoria Saxton doesn't quit and gets around Tamari Key. That'll be on the learning tape tomorrow in their film session.
Saxton just picked up her second foul. So over to the South Carolina bench she goes. Aaliyah Boston back in the game. Ray Burrell, she was 5 of 9 from the field, 10 points. Hey. Aaliyah Boston with her first field goal.
Just see how high Leticia Amihir got up. She's got a wingspan of 6'10" and a vertical jump of 27.9 inches.
Yeah, she had a 6-inch improvement on that vertical coming into this season. It paid off on that possession.
She played in a knee brace last season, and ever since that she has put that away and built up her strength, she's improved.
Foul on Tennessee on Tamari Key.
Yeah, as a guard, you've got to love it when you've got Amihir in down low. You can just throw it up around the rim, and South Carolina has just been able to play up top over the Lady Vols.
Henderson all day to shoot that three.
She has learned not to play rushed. She is playing with great patience and composure and understanding when to go fast, when to go slow, and when to go right into your shot.
Yeah, we had the chance to see South Carolina in that early game, that loss to NC State, and Destiny Henderson has come so far, especially when what you were talking about, knowing when to give the ball up or take her own shot.
Well, and patience of reading the defense. She read that the defense went underneath the screen, and she knocked it down.
South Carolina with a 7-point lead behind 10 points from Henny. Coach Landers, Destiny Henderson, 10 points, the only double-figure player for South Carolina right now. She's been pretty solid to start this game for the Gamecocks.
When your defense focuses so much on trying to stop the inside game or to crowd the paint, when you're facing South Carolina, that's where Destiny Henderson has to call her own number. And she has done a nice job of not forcing shots, but taking what the defense has given her.
South Carolina shooting 50% from the field to start this game. Leticia Amihir right over Tamari Key.
just paint points. When you're playing South Carolina, you got to decide what you're going to try to take away and go with gambles. But because Destiny Henderson has been hitting shots, now the defense comes out on Henderson and allows that opening.
Boston trying to help out Grissette, and she will. Tennessee just handed South Carolina the basketball.
Yeah, there'll be a long discussion in taking care of the basketball when these teams go to the locker room. Turnovers have been a focus for both of these coaches.
Both teams with six turnovers to start this game. Zaya Cook stuffed by Key. Tennessee ball.
Leticia Ami here. Just the little shot fake and the dribble. Once you get the defense to commit, you can just little shot fake, one dribble, pull up. Gives yourself space and able to score over the length of Tennessee.
Dawn Staley talked to us yesterday about the upside of Leticia Ami here. And she has told Leticia and the entire team that she feels like Ami here has the most upside on the team. And they're going to need her down the stretch when we get to the SEC tournament and the NCAA tournament.
Well, this is really the season where Amihair has gotten the most experience, most playing time. But when you're playing in the SEC, a lot of times instead of being patient and reading, and you only gain that through experience, you get rushed. And when you get rushed, what happens? You just go with what you're comfortable with. And she likes to go over that left shoulder, but she's got to wait, catch, see where the defense is, and decide which way to go.
Gets a block and takes it away from Marta Suarez. South Carolina is still struggling to hit the easy shots underneath.
Just look at the length that South Carolina has. And that's a me here off the bench. That's not even a Victoria Saxon or a Leah Boston that's in the starting lineup.
Well, Leticia Meher just picked up her second foul. So along with Victoria Saxon, she will take a seat. Saxon also has two fouls for Carolina.
Now Tennessee's got to find ways to score, and they need to play through number zero, Renaya Davis. Get her slashing, get her post-up opportunities. She does a nice job cutting off screens from the post.
Davis has no points yet tonight. Foul on Aaliyah Boston.
Yeah, Courtney, we did the Georgia game, and Georgia was able to pull off the win against Tennessee. But in that game, Renaya Davis did such a nice job of moving without the basketball. And when she does that, good things happen for Tennessee.
So South Carolina is in some foul trouble right now too, Carolyn. Leticia Meher is back in. She's got two fouls, but Aaliyah Boston and Victoria Saxton both on the bench for the Gamecocks. This could be an opportunity for Tennessee.
Well, this is when Tennessee's got to really take advantage of those two post players, the starters for South Carolina on the bench.
Russell back to a waiting Zaya Cook. Oh, and it's off of Tennessee. It'll stay with South Carolina.
Well, in Tennessee, daring South Carolina really to score from the perimeter. They're in that zone, but the two post players, the scoring threats for South Carolina, are on the bench. Why not? Now you can really play almost a sagging man, but make sure that you have coverage and have a hand up on South Carolina.
Anaya Russell on the baseline. Zaya Cook getting aggressive, but it stays with the Lady Vols.
Paint points. That is what South Carolina is looking for. Not settling for jumpers, even against the zone.
20 of South Carolina's 33 points have come in the paint.
NC Cassie now. I think Cassie Keshkatawa right there. She's got to make herself available in the paint, but she's got to finish when she gets the ball inside.
Two shots, neither will go for Keshkatawa. Cook dumps it off to Leticia Amihir. How about that play?
South Carolina sharing and moving the basketball like that. They're hard to guard. Zaya Cook didn't force the shot, but read the defense when it came to her and found the opening.
Carolina on a 13-1 run. Traveling on Suarez.
You just watched Zaya Cook, eyes up. Recognizes Suarez, runs at her. Ray Burrell rotates over. Cassie Keshkatawa there as well. And Amihir is just right in the middle of the lane, right place at the right time.
Leticia Amihir has spent time with Team Canada. Actually had to miss a couple of games last year to be with them for the FIBA qualifying tournament, but has that international experience.
Cassie
Somebody
Keshkatawa.
Lost a shoe.
It's Cassie. She's only got one foot, one shoe on her foot. She needs to come on down and play without the shoe, because right now Tennessee's 4-on-5. And Leticia Mehir recognized it. She was going to bring the trap.
Cassie's back, two shoes and all, stolen away by Grissette.
You know, Tennessee was so fluid in that first half against Texas A&M, very intentional of where they wanted to get the basketball. It's been a lot different in this first half against South Carolina. A lot less direct passes inside to the post.
Yeah, Kelly Harper has been preaching all season, pretty much since she got to Tennessee, or got back to Tennessee since she played there, to get the ball in the post, work everything through the post. Even if it's not a shot down low, they can kick back out.
But the other thing that the post players for Tennessee have to do, they got to work for the ball. And I don't see that as much either.
Keshkatawa gets the first. Tomorrow, our gymnastics doubleheader starts with the number one team in the nation, the Florida Gators, hosting number 15 Kentucky at 7 Eastern. Then number 25 Missouri is at the barn in Fayetteville to take on number 5 Arkansas right here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. I'm so excited to be on the call for that Florida-Kentucky meet tomorrow. Florida put up the highest score in the nation last week. Trinity Thomas had a perfect 10 on floor. Made SportsCenter top 10. It was awesome.
How many perfect scores has she had? I know you talk about her a lot this season.
Yeah, she has a perfect 10 on 3 apparatus. We're waiting for that gym slam. If she can get a perfect 10 on the vault, it could be tomorrow, so you got to tune in.
See, sell it, the tease. I'll be tuned in, Lyle.
Friday Night Heights. Hey. Ray Burrell right through the lane. Shot clock still on. Keshkatawa whistled for the foul.
Well, Ray Burrell in transition. This is one of the most dynamic parts of her game. She's going to find a way to get to the rack when she's got a full head of steam playing downhill.
We were tied up at 16 after the first quarter. South Carolina has been able to pull away as Tennessee only has 9 points in the second quarter.
Well, and right now, South Carolina dominating the boards. They're up 25-17 over Tennessee.
Nia Russell has to take it. It won't go, but a pretty good second quarter for South Carolina. They outscore the Lady Vols 21-9 in that second quarter. They lead 37-25. Let's get you to the studio with Alyssa. Welcome back to SEC Network Basketball presented by Regions. South Carolina looking for its 32nd straight SEC win. They lead here at halftime 37-25 over number 21 Tennessee. Courtney Lyle and national championship winning head coach Carolyn Peck with you. And we were tied after the first 10 minutes of this game, but then South Carolina outscored Tennessee 21-9 in that second quarter.
Well, and a lot of that had to do with attacking the paint for South Carolina and getting on the glass as well. When you're getting the ball in that orange area, that's the high percentage shot for South Carolina. And then the pursuit of the basketball, the offensive rebounding inside. And then the thing that I was impressed with South Carolina as well is they boxed out, and that was going to be a focus. I think in this second half, Tennessee's got to make a more concerted effort of their post players really establishing inside and calling for the basketball. Forget the offense. Just go plant inside and get the ball down low to your big girls.
First year for Tamari Key and Cassiana Cush-Kittawa, what they combined for in SEC play. But tonight, just 9 points between them and only 3 rebounds between them. Remember, they're facing the second-best rebounding team in the nation.
Well, I go back to their last game against Texas A&M. In the first half, Tamari Key and Cassie Cush-Kittawa looked the best that I have seen them all season. They established inside. They wanted the ball, but I have not seen that same intensity since halftime in Bryan College Station.
Also important to note, Renaya Davis did not score for Tennessee. She had 25 points on Sunday. Ray Burrell certainly did score. She's the only Lady Vol in double figures now with 14. And South Carolina starts out with a turnover, the eighth turnover for the Gamecocks.
Well, Burrell is just creating offense and does a nice job of to hesitate and shot fake because she knows South Carolina is looking to block everything.
South Carolina's shot blocking abilities really impacted Tennessee in that first half. Davis is fouled by Bree Beal.
We were talking about Renaya Davis having not scored. Well, with Bree Beal on her, Beal a lot of times gets the assignment of defending the best offensive threat on the opponent. So now how can Renaya Davis free herself to get away and create those scoring opportunities away from Bree Beal?
First point for Davis. She does have 6 rebounds tonight, but 0 for 4 from the field.
Now Tennessee extending their defense, little 2-2-1 action.
Destiny Henderson will set things up for the Gamecocks. She had double-figure points in the first half with 10. Her season average is 12. Cook on the drive.
So now Bree Beal is on Ray Burrell. Zaya Cook has the assignment of defending Renaya Davis. I would take Cook down and post her up.
Jordan Walker throws it away. Tennessee with 9 turnovers. Saxon at the elbow, won't get the bucket, but will be fouled by Tamari Key. That is her second.
It's only 2, but she's got to recognize she doesn't even need to be that close to Victoria Saxon. Tamari Key can really back up, and it would allow Cassie Cush-Kittawa to play behind Aaliyah Boston, force Victoria Saxon to prove she can hit that shot from the free throw line area. Good with Saxon right here, she's pretty much going to be, she's got to prove that she can hit that shot consistently. I would back up there. No need to foul her right there.
10-point lead for South Carolina. They've led by as many as 16.
Yes!
And that's the third foul on Tamari Key.
Again, Victoria Saxon boxing out Key on the shot. Saxon comes over and then again goes to the backside. Hands up there, just used her body to box out.
South Carolina has done a really nice job of boxing out Tennessee.
Nice!
Foul on the floor before the shot on Horston. Her second.
I thought that was going to be an offensive foul because it looked to me like Saxon had displaced Horston down low.
Knock it down, Zay.
Cook on the pull-up. Zaya Cook just 4 points. She's 2 of 12 from the field. Boston steps around Kush Kittawa.
She's just too good. The agility that Aaliyah Boston has, she's worked on her ball handling abilities as well, which makes her so tough to guard.
She's also crashing the glass like crazy. That's her 11th rebound.
Tennessee's going to have to get organized.
Destiny Henderson in the corner. She's up to 13 points. That's her third three-pointer tonight.
Well, Tennessee having Renaya Davis at the four.
Kush Kittawa finishes.
Well, she posted. She called for it. She knew that play was run for her, isolated against Boston.
And when Tennessee's been at its best, their post players have demanded the basketball.
And that's the thing post players have to understand. You have to do your work early. She had 2 feet in the paint. She had Boston on her backside. That allows her to have options offensively. See, now you could go with a high-low, get Davis out of there again, and isolate Kush Kittawa down low.
Davis tries to go over Bree Beal, and she'll be called for her second foul. Renaya Davis, still no field goals, her only points coming from the free throw line. Lily Grissette checks in, replacing Bree Beal, who's got 2 fouls. First one is good for Renaya. Well, Sunday night at 8 Eastern, 7 Central, right here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app, we'll have a 2-hour recap of this year's Women's Swimming and Diving Championships. It's coming up on Sunday.
Tennessee to turn things up. Again, the full court pressure, but Destiny Henderson, it doesn't seem to bother her one bit.
Second opportunity for South Carolina. They've had plenty of those. 11 offensive rebounds for the Gamecocks.
Well, that was a much better job of Tennessee boxing South Carolina out.
Jordan Walker for three. Tennessee has not hit a three-pointer. They're 0 for 3. Ray Burrell sees an opening and attacks.
That's really been the best offense for Tennessee tonight is Ray Burrell just breaking a play to make a play.
She's got 16 points. And there's a foul on Burrell, but she's leading Tennessee right now.
Well, they're going to need more of this from Ray Burrell to get themselves back in this ball game. She's going to have to take and put the Lady Bat balls on her back to get it done.
Well, ESPN is celebrating Black History always, and we're taking a look at some historical hidden figures. Trish Roberts was the first Black female basketball player at Tennessee. She transferred in from Emporia State and actually was a teammate of Pat Summitt's on the 1976 Olympic team. They took the silver medal, still owns 11 Lady Vol records, and was inducted into the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame in 2000.
Well, not just any records, points per game, 29.9 per game. Field goals made in a season, 428. Rebounds in a season, 467. Points in a season, she almost had 1,000 points in one season, 987. She left her mark and really opened the door or demonstrated what could be done playing as a Lady Vol.
We asked Kelly Harper about her. She said she still keeps, they talked a few weeks ago on the phone briefly. She still keeps up with the Lady Vols. What's going on with the team? What's going on right now is we're keeping an eye on Ray Burrell, who tweaked her ankle on one of those last plays. She's in one of the wings right now of the arena. Getting stretched out, we'll keep an eye on her. South Carolina really took over this game in the second quarter as Renaya Davis finally has her first field goal of the game. She started 0 for 4.
Well, I think Renaya Davis can take over in this third quarter, especially having a post player guarding her. She will have the ability to go off the bounce, just to hit her mid-range jump shot. I expect to see more of that.
Boston. Tennessee was outscored 21-9 in the second quarter. Put back for Horston is good.
I think as long as South Carolina has Aaliyah Boston shooting a contested shot from the free throw line, Tennessee would be happy because that puts the Lady Vols in a better position to box out.
Saxton trying to get around Renaya Davis. And Tennessee does get the timeout called before Carolina was able to tie up the ball. 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. South Carolina on top, but Tennessee threatening. Well, the good news is Ray Burrell just rejoined the Tennessee huddle moments ago. We were keeping an eye on her status after this play right here. Watch her ankle. It's her left ankle as she tweaks it just a little bit. Got caught on Zaya Cook's foot. They took her over into one of the wings right off the court. Stretched her out a little bit. But she's Tennessee's leading scorer in this game with 16 points, 8 of 16 from the field.
She's the only Lady Vol in double figures. She's the only one that has really pushed the issue offensively. Tennessee's going to have to get some help from their post game inside. Cassie Keshketawa, even though she's got Aaliyah Boston on her, when she establishes, she can finish.
Oh, Raniah Davis can certainly finish too. Tennessee trailed by 16 points. Now it's a four-point game. Boston on the move. Foul on Davis. South Carolina has been outscored 17-9 here in the third quarter.
Well, Raniah Davis with Victoria Saxton on her. A post player is going to give her a step, going to give her room because she's so dangerous going off the bounce that she's able to have space for that shot.
Boston at the free throw line. 7 points, 13 rebounds for Aaliyah Boston. She had 10 rebounds in the first half.
It was just another day at the office for Aaliyah Boston.
Yeah, she does not let her offense affect any other part of her game. She still crashes the boards like crazy.
I've just seen a lot of maturation of Aaliyah Boston just throughout her sophomore season.
Big bucket for Destiny Salary. Stolen away by Salary. She's got help too. It's Jordan Walker. Going to the free throw line. It's a two-point game.
Tennessee not trying to get it all back at once, but a little bit at a time and scoring off of their defense and attacking in transition. The focus, the finish, and the opportunity to get to the free throw line. Lady Vols got to love it.
Jordan Walker got the start at point guard tonight for Tennessee. Completes the three-point play. Now it's a one-point game.
And South Carolina has shown at times their offense will sputter. And I asked Dawn Staley about that, and she said missing layups or missing open shots has been key. They've got to be able to execute and find those easy baskets and knock it down, just like that.
8 points for Zaya Cook. Called a foul on the floor. Coach Kittawa hit the deck pretty hard.
Right there, Aaliyah Boston could have been called for a foul because she had the hook on the box out. You saw the arm wrapped around Cassie Keshkettawa.
And that's going to be her third foul, so Aaliyah Boston checks out of the game. That's big as Tennessee's on a 12-4 run. You can add to that, Raniah Davis has found her groove. Pushing tempo. Layup, Jordan Horston. Tennessee trailed by 16 points. They have a one-point lead in the third quarter.
Tennessee has turned up their defense, and they have picked up the speed in transition. Horston, with her length, continues to the basket for the finish. The momentum has definitely swung in the direction, in the favor of the Lady Vols.
Carolyn, this is a huge game for Tennessee. Charlie Cream says Tennessee can move up to a number 3 seed in the tournament with a win over South Carolina tonight. This was the committee's top 16 reveal on Monday. South Carolina was number 2 overall. They're a number 1 seed. Tennessee, 13th overall at a number 4 seed. But a win tonight over the number 2 team in the nation would be huge.
Well, absolutely would be huge because remember, another team that could have helped the net rating for Tennessee was Mississippi State. That was supposed to have been played Tuesday. That game's been postponed. So every opportunity to get a significant win for the Lady Vols is huge.
South Carolina projected as a number one seed. Right now, Tennessee a four. But again, they could move up to a three with a win. Tennessee 3-3 against ranked opponents this season.
These games down the stretch are going to be key, and especially if they're played, because of the number of games that have been either canceled or postponed, will they be able to be fit in to determine the seeding for the SEC tournament?
Zaya Cook put South Carolina back on top. Horston running the show for Tennessee. And Renaya Davis, who has 11 points in the third quarter, will look to add to it at the free throw line.
And I don't blame Kelly Harper one bit. I would run the offense through Renaya Davis right now. She has found her ability to, and she loves going to the baseline. That baseline drive area is right up her alley. So you either have to foul her or she's going to score on you.
Coming off a team-high 25-point performance against Texas A&M. 12 points, all of her points, here in the third quarter.
And since SEC play, Renaya Davis has averaged 18 points a game. She's really found her stride. It was a little bumpy at the start of the season, but once SEC season started, she seems to be picked back up and really demonstrate being that. She could be a potential SEC Player of the Year.
Well, she's on the Wooden Award late season watch list for the Player of the Year. Henderson back to Boston at the free throw line. Got it.
Gosh, she's good. 6'5", a sophomore. What a talent.
Her 11th double-double of the season already on the score sheet for Aaliyah Boston. Lady Vols can take the last shot of the quarter. Horston off the screen. At the SEC logo too much. And I think Zaya Cook traveled. 0.3 on the clock.
Now Tennessee could throw it just up around the rim. It's got to be a tap with 0.3.
South Carolina will sub out Aaliyah Boston for Alyssa Wesolek. And no time to do much there. But what a ball game we have on Rocky Top. Tennessee trailed by 16 points. It's a one-point game right now.
Tennessee just chipped away a little bit at a time. They're at home. They're taking care of business in the third. We're in for a special treat in this fourth quarter.
Look at this score to start the fourth quarter here in Knoxville, South Carolina, leading but just by a point. Tennessee outscored them 28-17 in the third quarter. A lot of that has to do with Renaya Davis, who did not score in the first half, had 13 points, Carolyn Peck, in the third quarter.
I think it took Renaya Davis a little while to figure out how to create her opportunities. She had different people guarding her, and so trying to find that rhythm was a little bit difficult. But the thing that Renaya Davis did in that third quarter is she moved, and moved without the basketball. When that happens for her, her offense starts to click.
For South Carolina on their end, what can they change? They had a 16-point lead in this game.
Well, offensively, again, finding just a fluidity within their offense. They have had spurts this season where they have just gone scoreless for periods of time, and it has really been costly.
Boston trying to break down Kush Kidawa, foul on the floor.
Wow,
on Kush Kidawa.
I want to see that again. Kelly, I don't know. I didn't see a foul either. Kesh Kidawa had both hands up. I guess just there at the end when her hands broke the plane, but wow.
Cook on the layup. Pushkitawa still in the game for Tennessee. Tamari Key is on the bench with three fouls. South Carolina ball.
Now Tennessee's got to recognize that Russell, Anaya Russell, is guarding Renaya Davis. That's a freshman on a senior. I would try to exploit that all day long.
Here's Russell. And the layup woes continue. Foul on South Carolina. It's on Letitia Ami here, her third. So now can Tennessee exploit the matchup you were talking about? Anaya Russell guarding Renaya Davis. There they give it to Davis. Cook will push. She's got numbers. Jump ball and possession arrow pointing Tennessee's way.
One of the things in the first half that went well for South Carolina was Destiny Henderson, and Destiny pushing in transition. I like her decision making a little bit better at the point. Let Cook be the scorer, the beneficiary of the pass, but to let Destiny Henderson push your team in transition.
Ray Burrell, you see her come back into the game. Tweaked her ankle in the third quarter. Tennessee was able to go on a big run, though, with her on the bench. She's their leading scorer tonight with 16 points. Boston in the high post.
You watch every time Aaliyah Boston touches the basketball, the attention she attracts.
Henderson wanted the foul call. Jordan Walker will start running. And gets fouled by Russell.
Now, I think there's the foul there. Jordan Horston got away with that one there. No call. Destiny Henderson's like, what happened? And then Tennessee able to head the other direction. And Walker is the beneficiary now, getting to the free throw line.
Yeah, the first foul called on the freshman, Anaya Russell. Walker gets one of two. This game was tied at 16 points apiece after the first quarter. South Carolina outscored Tennessee 21-6 in that second quarter, but it was time for a Tennessee takeover in the third.
Now getting Aaliyah Boston down low. That's where your money is, right there. If you're not getting scoring happening and Aaliyah Boston is playing up high, put her down low, put her on the block.
13 points, 13 rebounds for Aaliyah Boston. Ray Burrell at the top of the key. No big deal.
She has daylight. Look, every time she pulls the trigger, I think that shot's going in. She does too.
Back inside to Boston. Bread and butter for South Carolina.
Now for Tennessee, Cassie Keshkettawa, she's got to want that battle. Yeah, want that match. But she's got to be able to finish. The centers, Aaliyah Boston and Cassie Keshkettawa. That time Aaliyah Boston won that battle. But on the other end, Cassie Keshkettawa's got to have that payback mentality. Okay, you scored on me. I'm coming back the other end. Give it to me. Let me show you what I can do.
Renia Davis has picked up her third foul for Tennessee. It is South Carolina ball. Davis still on the floor.
So now Tamari Key has the assignment of defending Aaliyah Boston.
Almost a turnover. Back out to Anaya Russell off the mark. Davis went straight to the basket, and Ray Burrell knew it.
Now, Tennessee's got to always keep an eye out for, try to find number zero right now.
15 points for Renia Davis, all in the second half. Henderson the pull up.
And Henderson has had one heck of a game, just being that answer when South Carolina hits a dry spell.
Give the ball to Renia Davis. That is the game plan. Tie game.
Davis seems to take her game to another level. The bigger the game is, the bigger Renia Davis plays.
South Carolina has won 31 straight SEC games. That's in danger right now. Great defense by Burrell. Walker running to the hoop. And one! Tennessee just gutsy right now.
Tennessee right now running in transition again. Jordan Walker with the finish and getting to the free throw line. She started this game in place of Jordan Horston, and she has given the Lady Vols big minutes, finishing big plays.
Walker with 6 points, 4 rebounds, 3 assists. Tennessee hasn't beaten a top five team since 2017. They've got a 2-point lead right now. Lady Vols just lucked out there as Henderson falls out of bounds with the ball. Different Tennessee team in the second half, shooting 58% from the field against the number two team in the nation. After trailing by 16 points, Tennessee has a 2-point lead over the number two team in the nation, and a lot of that has to do with 18 points from Renia Davis in the second half.
And she's done it so many different ways, a mid-range jumper, but she started moving without the basketball on cuts, and then, oh yeah, extend your range, show it, Renia Davis, from the 3-point area. She has really put the Lady Vols on her back in this second half. All 18 of her points have come in this second half.
Renia Davis is a difference maker for Tennessee. Her and Burrell combined for over 33 points per game. Tonight, they've got 37 points. I mean, it's just a different team when they're on.
When they're clicking on the same night, that's just trouble for their opponents. The other part, too, I think that helped. Even though Cassie Kishketawa is on the bench, she also flexed her muscles inside. Even if the ball doesn't go inside, when you have a post presence, that opens up things for the perimeter.
South Carolina won the battle in the paint in the first half. Right now, we're even on paint points with 38 apiece.
Well, a lot of that has to do, I believe, with how Cassie Kishketawa battled inside, keeping Aaliyah Boston occupied. Now will Tamari Key keep that up down the stretch in this fourth quarter?
Block for Key. Rejected, Destiny Henderson. And then got a rebound on the other end, got herself to the free throw line.
Tamari Key getting it done on both ends. The big block. She keeps it in bounds and then stays after it. Goes to the offensive glass on the other end. That's exactly what Kelly Harper needs.
Tennessee was on a 6-0 run before that free throw miss. Boston, more importantly, picked up her fourth foul on that play.
So now South Carolina has to score. And when they've needed buckets, clutch buckets, they've gone to Aaliyah Boston.
Another block from Key.
Tamari Key has become the eraser for the Lady Vols.
Saxton battling for it. Foul whistled on Tennessee.
Tamari Key has just recognized how to use her length. Extend her arms, keep your body away, and to keep it in bounds. Don't just swat it out of bounds and get a stoppage of play. Block it, keep it in bounds so that the basketball can head to your basket.
She's already in the top 10 in career blocks at Tennessee, and she's just a sophomore.
Tamari Key face guarding or fronting Aaliyah Boston. She's getting no looks right now.
Tennessee did a great job of boxing out right there.
That much improved from the first half.
Worston running out of time. Give it to Davis. That's a pretty good decision. She's only got 20 points in the second half.
Just 20 points, you say, Courtney Lyle, but Renia Davis, look, she added them up. Down low, posting up. Shot clock running down, no problem for number zero right there. Just elevate, release, and finish.
The fifth time this season, Renia Davis has hit the 20-point mark, including in back-to-back games. Tennessee now leading 68-62. They trailed by 16 points in this game.
But the resilience, the no panic, the confidence that this team, the Lady Vols, have shown in each other, that you can never count them out. They always show that they have that bite, that extra run that gives them a chance.
Under 3 minutes to play on Rocky Top, an upset brewing. And it's a turnover for South Carolina. These coaches getting a lot of national recognition already as Kelly Harper has her team with a lead, a 4-point lead over the number two team in the nation. Kelly Harper and Dawn Staley joined Gary Blair as the three SEC coaches on the Naismith Coach of the Year late season list. They've done some incredible things with their program. It's impressive to have three in the SEC.
Well, and Dawn Staley doing a little coaching them up right now. She's got her most athletic team in. She wanted to go that full court pressure to force the turnover. Now you're going to see a little offense for defense rotations happening.
Anderson running out of room. He'll swing it to Boston. Aaliyah Boston for three, no. Big rebound, though, by Lily Grissette. And a foul on Renaya Davis, her fourth. Remember, South Carolina has won 31 straight SEC games. Tennessee holds the record in the conference. They won 36 back from 2010 to 2012. Tennessee's hoping they can end that streak tonight. Oh, wow. A foul called on Tamari Key.
Is that five on Key?
It is. She's done.
If Key would have done, would have been better off just to fall, take the charge, but continue to move. It's as if impeding on the progress of the offensive player. Tennessee's really going to miss her length on the court over these last 2 minutes because she has been the eraser inside. Anytime South Carolina's gotten the ball in the lane, Tamari Key has been swatting that stuff out of there.
Things just got a little bit easier for Aaliyah Boston and anybody who's driving in the lane for South Carolina.
So now I would expect South Carolina again to bring the pressure, bring the press, and try to force Tennessee into turnovers.
Both teams in the bonus, both teams with two timeouts. Walker turns it over. Held ball. And possession arrow pointing to South Carolina.
Just bringing the pressure, the run and jump from South Carolina. That basketball's like a hot potato. And Zaya Cook with the second effort to go after the ball.
I thought that might be a travel on Cook. She slid down the floor with the ball.
I was thinking that too. But now,
I don't know if she had possession.
South Carolina has got to get a score, and that's it, attacking the basket. If you're not going to get the layup, you at least have to get yourself to the free throw line.
Zaya Cook will go there, a 78% free throw shooter. She's 2 for 2 on the evening. Well, coming up next, the SEC Now team will have a complete breakdown of this game as well as interviews with coaches and players. You can see it coming up after we're done right here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. Lots to break down in this one. Still a minute 48 to go. Tennessee has the lead after trailing by 16.
And again, South Carolina bringing the full court pressure. South Carolina doesn't have to foul. They just need to try to get a stop. Where Tennessee attack going to the basket. Just like that.
Great look for Jordan Horston.
Now Tennessee could really look at some zone action because South Carolina is 1 for 6 from the three-point line.
Oh, heartbreaker for Zaya Cook.
Horston recognizes that she's got a post player on her. She's just a little bit quicker, a little bit better at handling the basketball and attacks the rim.
Libby Grissett picked up her third foul. It sends Renaya Davis to the free throw line, who has been the key for Tennessee in this second half. 20 points, all of them coming in the second half to help Tennessee stage this comeback.
It's just as if Renaya Davis just decided, okay, I didn't get my points in the first half. I'm taking over regardless of who's guarding me. Just to play her game and the activity that she had without the basketball, I feel like really got her offense going.
South Carolina calls timeout. They will have one timeout remaining. Dawn Staley can advance the basketball. Remember, this is a huge game for Tennessee. They're trying to boost their standings. In the top 16 reveal on Monday, Tennessee was number 13 overall. That puts them at a 4 seed. A win tonight over South Carolina moves them to a 3 seed. But Carolina still has a chance here. What does South Carolina have to do?
Well, South Carolina, number one, they need to get the ball in, and they're going to have to score quick. They don't need a three. They could run a pick-and-roll situation with Aaliyah Boston, having Destiny Henderson, especially with her speed, put Destiny Henderson and Aaliyah Boston in a two-man game and make Cassie Keshkatawa make a decision. Am I going to rotate off to rotate to a distant Destiny Henderson and leave a target of Aaliyah Boston? I think that would be a good option.
South Carolina still has one timeout left. They throw it up in the air, and it's intercepted by Tennessee. Taken back by the Gamecocks, and Olivia Thompson travel. A huge turnover by South Carolina. South Carolina's got a foul, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And that's what I'm looking at. Who South Carolina would want to foul? Ray Burrell's 81, probably Jordan Walker. Jordan Walker shoots 57% from the three-point line.
Well, the ball goes into the hands of Renaya Davis, and so she will go to the free throw line, an 80% free throw shooter. Hasn't missed there tonight. Boston back in for South Carolina. They still have a timeout.
But I don't think South Carolina uses their timeout here. Make or miss, just to get it and bring it. Because South Carolina only has one timeout left. You see Dawn Staley calling the play. Aaliyah Boston asking, South Carolina should not call a timeout right now. They should rebound it in back or get it in and go. But they need to go fast.
They're taking a lot of time. Cook finds a lane, an easy two for the Gamecocks.
Now they need to foul. South Carolina needs to foul again right away.
They foul Jordan Horston.
See, Isaiah Cook rejected the screen, didn't panic, didn't pull up for a three, but continued to attack the basket. But you've got a foul right away. Same thing. I don't think South Carolina needs to call, well, a timeout now. They need to get it and go. They just need to go and score as quickly as possible. Where Tennessee would be, it would benefit Tennessee right now just to foul. Put South Carolina at the free throw line. They're only, the most they can get would be two. Cook's got to go quicker than this.
She'll take the three, and it won't go. Into the hands of Renaya Davis. One straight SEC wins is no more. A big win in Big Orange Country for the Lady Vols for the first time since 2017. Tennessee defeats a top five team, and they trailed by 16 points.
No panic, no worry. As long as you have Renaya Davis on your team, she was huge in that second half. 24 points from number zero that really helped Tennessee to protect home court against the number two team in the country.
A signature win for Kelly Harper and her Lady Vols. They take down South Carolina, overcome a 16-point deficit behind 24 points from Renaya Davis. An outstanding performance for the Lady Vols, a win they won't forget for a long time, taking down the number two team in the nation. Lady Vols victorious on the Summit, 75-67.
Holy cow.